Long crew update, wow.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
They'll be starting crops soon. Can't tell if they have enough water or too much. I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids, but I always loved them. I daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
I like that idea.
It'd be good to bring something beautiful across galaxies.
Everyone in the initiative has their something beautiful. Mm. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go.
It's like dangerous music.
Why? The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
Hmm. That was cold of her.
Wow. You fight side by side, then she gives you the brush off?
It hurt. One big kick out of the nest. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder.
Huh.
Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What appealed to you?
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place, even AI, or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me that's okay?
Dad could inspire people.
He gave you a dream to work toward. He was good at that.
Who doesn't want to belong? Especially somewhere like the Initiative. So I gave the Initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted. My rose garden. I thought I knew what I was going to be.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
None of this is fair.
I get that. We've all had a lot of disappointments lately.
You're doing well. For having no training, being your second isn't so bad. And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses too.
Aww. Definitely seeing the more human side of Cora here. I like it. And she does look different. Right, so there's more, probably more options.
Ryder?
We only have the Asari Ark.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
Okay.
See you later, Cora.
I'll be here.
Open Saskatchewan.
Messing with that vault feels like early brain surgery. Just poking and hoping.
As long as it helps us to live here, I don't care how the vault's doing it.
Magnificently. That's how.
I prefer tech with more exposed bolts. If you can't open it, you don't own it.
I guess people's voices really travel in this ship. Hello, Gil.
Hey, Ryder. What's the story?
Oh, he doesn't have anything to say. Okay.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
I I have unused research data. Okay. Liam?
Prodromos. Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it?
Sorry.
We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
So you think I have skill as a Pathfinder?
Just wondering what you think of how I'm doing at the job.
I'm committed to the initiative. You're Pathfinder. It's as simple as it gets.
Nah.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Well, we're working together. It'd be hard not to talk later. Liam Vetra's down, I guess, yeah. Where is she? She's this way? So Vetra's ahead. Somehow I missed her. Oh, right there.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
Well, that's why it's an adventure.
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone. Bleh.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
Yeah, to find a home.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
So is there anyone special in your life?
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Sid?
No, just me and Sid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh. You mean like... Oh.
Oh.
No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Hopefully soon.
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
A romantic? I wasn't expecting that. Then again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic.
I guess.
Anyway.
Yep, I'll let you go.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Okay, so... Drac and Sam are ahead up there somewhere. Still learning my way around this place. Okay. Oh, so that's where the kitchen is? Gotta turn around here. Hold on a second.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Call her Roshan? Well, no trouble is ideal.
I like the no-trouble plan. How about we stick with that?
Kett said not too much trouble, kid. Not no trouble. The Kett makes sure some trouble's always coming for you.
That's not reassuring.
Life out here ain't reassuring. You'll get used to it.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Well, the Nexus has supplies.
Your people had to know what it'd be like when you left the Nexus.
We did, but there weren't a lot of options. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
What about Cash?
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Rushan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to.
Well, that means granddaughter.
As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Well, then I understand why you left.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Okay. Anything more to say?
Ryder, you meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in Assistant Director.
Spender.
Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for Kesh ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
Hmm. Tell me about the uprising.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Kesh is alone on that station now.
You worried about her?
You think someone might try to hurt Kesh?
More like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Mm-hmm. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station, without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
Probably. Tell me about Kesh.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
Yeah, she's pretty cool. I like her. Once I realize that she's actually not a male Krogan.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Hmm. So, Drak, tell me about Drak.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
What's your combat experience?
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
I guess you have one of those. And what about this Krogan colony?
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable, the works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
Corkrow roots, huh? Do you know Vetra?
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
Kinda. You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for Kesh right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
Yeah, she's pretty awesome that way.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Cash's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Cash all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
Poor guy. What do you think about Sam?
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comms, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you think that? I mean, I agree. I just want to hear what he says.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost.
Well, Sam and I are a package deal.
Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
I like the way he talks. So do you have any Krogan war stories?
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a pyjack scratch its butt?
Any combat advice to share?
Anything about the Kett? Or combat in general?
Well, common Kett are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
Anything else?
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it.
Wraiths?
Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you.
Like banshees?
Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
I guess there's nothing else.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Destined are annoying.
Okay, quick. I've got more.
Got some crazy mist that hides them from view. They're friends, too. Take a Destined down, and that mist goes away. Makes them a prime target, if you ask me. Perfect for grenade practice.
I've seen at least one of the Destined. I didn't notice the mist, though.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
There's just something wrong about the Kett.
Yeah?
The absolute single-mindedness.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
So, Chosen, it's not good to let too many of them get close to you at once. If they hit your shields, take a step back. Let me handle them. Bet you anything they're not used to being rushed by a Krogan.
Just saying all this is cool, but she should say random sayings other than, tell me more about fighting Kett.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Fire and explosives are good against anything with heavy armor. Or anything, really. Generally, no one likes being set on fire.
Generally? There's a story behind this.
Ha, there sure is.
So what's the story about getting set on fire?
You mentioned that people generally don't like being set on fire.
I was hoping you'd ask. So, about 400 years ago, give or take a decade, me and my outfit were pinned down during a skirmish with another merc group. So I'd pull off my usual stunt, charge ahead and breach their barricade. Pop my flamethrower and get ready to let go. Only to see them all screaming and running away. Turns out, I crashed through a shipment of Turian brandy on my way in. Never even noticed I was on fire. But they sure did. Never seen a pack of mercs panic that badly before.
I had noticed a while ago, but I just haven't said anything. The way this is, like, strapped on here. Almost like bone strapped onto more bone.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Ascendant. Keep your distance. Don't let him get you in those force fields. Pop that little orb, then shoot him in the head, just like anything else.
Pop the little orb, huh?
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Fiends, kid. Even I'm not gonna mess with those at close range. Keep your distance.
Not fun.
Shoot them into red fleshy bits, or I guess in the face if you can't flank them.
He's got a lot of advice.
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Shoot stuff and don't die. Always works for me.
Okay, are we done then?
Tell me more about fighting Kett.
Shoot stuff and don't die. Always works for me.
I'll talk to you later.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Do you call everyone kid?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.
Interesting. Do I have anything else to say to you?
I've seen a lot of shit in my life, but that vault certainly was a first. Things are gonna be interesting with you around, kid.
Well, you didn't come with us in the vault. But I try my best.
Doesn't matter what life throws at me. It's what I make of it, right?
You keep that going, you just might live as long as I have. Minus zero at the end.
We can talk more later.
Sure.
Tell me more about fighting Kett. Emails that you already looked at. That's our wardrobe stuff. I'm not gonna mess around with that for now. You have to check in with Sam. Oh, Sam's back there, right. Sam's in here. Sam, yeah.
Hello, Sarah. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
Oh, you have? Memory triggers. We found some more.
What's the latest on the memory triggers?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Okay.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
So I guess that's the model we found in our father's room. The Normandy. I think. And we got space for more things. Oh, we have a Krogan thingy here. He looks like he's freaking out. So I guess we'll gradually get mementos and stuff of our journey, which is cool. Now the doctor, yeah, she's upstairs. So Drac and Sam, Gil, oh, Lexi. Oh no, we talked to Lexi. PB, Kalo, Suvi. We're done. We're done with crew update? What? This brings us right up to the bridge. Or by the bridge. Didn't miss anyone, did I? Let me just double check. We are on this floor. Nothing on that floor. Vetra. Liam. I don't know why I feel like I missed somebody. Alright. Wow. Over an hour for crew update. Cool. That's awesome looking. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Join me in the next episode when we actually head back to the Nexus and we're going to wrap up some quests, or at least I'm assuming some of them are going to be wrapped up. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, and endure. And enduring, grow strong.